Someone remind us that we have to go back down this road with Bob Kelly, because we got Chris Knight and...
of course we do. Chris Knight, Opie. Don't call him Peter Brady.
Chris Knight and his lovely, lovely girlfriend have just arrived for a little interview.
You did that with Greg Brady for a long time.
I understand that. Yes, Ben? What do you got? What?
Yeah.
You have any gum?
We saw her boobs way before we saw her. What the hell's going on?
The whole atmosphere out there changes when, like, a hot girl walks in.
Holy crap. Like,
everybody but is Peter here, too?
It's not Peter.
I mean, Chris Knight, sorry.
That's still Knight.
All right, we'll talk to them. What is the show called? My Fair Brady, right? My Fair Brady.
It's like My Fair Lady, but they put the Brady.
Gotcha.
Anytime a Brady's involved, they got to switch a word, make it Brady.
All right, we'll talk to them in just a few minutes here, and then we'll get to Bob.
Yeah, look at you.
Bob Kelly.
Oh, boy.
Talk to Peter Brady.
I'm gonna take a poo.
And his lovely, lovely girlfriend next. All right, we got some big, big stars coming into the studio. Big stars.
That's right.
Christopher Knight and Adrian Curry from Holy My Fair Jesus. Brady.
Hello.
Good morning.
Couple.
What's up, guys?
Did you just wake up? You look like... What am I getting myself into?
I always have this look of trepidation.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Trepidation.
I lost my ball.
That's fine. What'd you have under the baseball?
Adrian grabbed it.
Tossing around? Yeah.
There you go.
There's your ball.
Now it's all's well with the world.
Wow.
Did you have to wear that? You're killing us.
Yeah, I did. Sadly.
Oh, my God. Jeez.
Unbelievable.
Amazing.
You really pulled it together, didn't you, Chris?
Yeah, I've been gifted here.
God damn, dude. And I don't like the fact that you fight it on the show.
Why She's not?
Unbelievable.
He likes men.
I would... honey, who doesn't? Who doesn't? They play video games.
It's they play video games all day long.
It's scary.
I guess we should explain. We're all staring at your
beautifulness.
Your beautifulness.
I know brawliness.
Well,
no bra.
It's one thing that it's no bra, but it's
perfect.
Yeah.
They're pretty much out.
Perfect.
Thanks.
It's like and I saw that on Rome last night.
I love that show. There's a lot of nudity on there.
Yeah, it's great.
And like sex and in front of like their mom and all.
Last night was a little much.
I didn't
a
see
man
it.
Junk. Yeah.
You got a man junk last night.
Well, Anthony was talking about how there's too much too much naked hogs.
Yeah, too much guy
was it
cock.
Was it the cock or the size of the cock that bothered you?
Size.
Size.
Oh, it was awful. Huge, huge, big man. Yeah.
I didn't see that.
You missed last night's episode.
Oh.
On demand.
She's going to want
the
DVD set.
The last episode I saw
now.
Is when they were prying that guy's eye out, and didn't they cut off his ear?
Yeah, that was a good one.
His thumbs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
What
that's
time did you get up to look as beautiful as you are right now?
Like he was talking
I woke
Chris.
Up at 5:30, and then...
Well, there's a contrast, because you woke up like we wake up.
No, he woke up at 5:30.
Just roll out of bed, quick shower, throw a t-shirt on, you're good to go, right? It looks like you've been up for hours getting ready for
this. I am very proud that I'm the only woman that can get ready in 40 minutes. In the shower, out, you know, lotion
really?
Everywhere. Yep, 40 minutes.
Lotion everywhere.
It's a dream.
Hey, how's our friend Barry doing?
Barry's doing okay.
Barry
used
to do our show all the time. I don't know if he's ever talked about us, but we all were buddy-buddy for a while there. And I actually...
when he lived back here in New York?
No, I actually, when we were off the air for 2 years, I actually saw his groovy pad, too, at the top of the hill a few times.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
she's tapping you.
What happened?
There's hot
I don't know. It doesn't
all
matter.
All.
Yeah, well, your picture's got to get up there.
Oh, wow. That one had her boobs hanging out.
Yeah.
Well, there's a...
Lindsay Lohan when she was hot before she lost
all
the weight.
Yeah, we got a wall filled with very, very hot celebrity photos. And,
I'm not so into Paris,
and now there's no interview because of it.
Paris has no butt. Paris needs a butt.
Paris,
she needs a butt.
You think she needs a butt?
Oh, yeah. She's got great perky boobies, but she has absolutely
I actually saw her in Vegas at the Hard Rock, and she has a spaded shovel ass.
You know what, though? She's got a fuck me. Oh, can we talk openly here?
She can take it like a pro.
Yeah, you can curse.
She cut her man off who was talking about his career and friends because there was tits on the wall. Yes.
It happens all the time. I'm totally used to it.
Oh, God bless you. What are you talking about?
Set walks by, they're pointed out for me. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I had a boring story anyway. Whatever.
Go on.
I used to visit.
Was it about boobs?
No, I mean, I just want to know how Barry's doing. That's all, because we haven't seen him in a while.
You know, Barry's doing well. He's going through a tough passage right now. But I think that he's got a court date in November, and I think things are going to clear up, hopefully, well for him.
Last time we saw him was at the premiere party for My Fair Brady, and he had this really hot blonde with him, so I think he's doing
really?
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, he's going to war.
He is going to war.
It's war. Well, yeah, it's about custody. It's all about custody.
What the fuck happened?
His ex seems like a bitch. No offense.
Just, you know.
I hung out with them, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 times, and it seemed like they were in love. They had a kid together, and all of a sudden, it made the tabloids that they're getting a divorce, and it's really ugly.
This
so.
Has happened to me, and she doesn't get it.
Yeah.
But all of a sudden, that's all happening, and then left turn.
Well, you people...
And you're sitting there going, what?
That sounds like gold-digging succubus devils, if you ask me.
But
it could be just women.
Did they have a prenup?
There was no signs of trouble in the household. That's what I'm saying.
I heard she was making all the money in the relationship.
That's crazy.
As far as the prenup goes.
It's not about money. It's about custody.
Yeah,
she didn't want to live in L.A. anymore.
You can take kids.
So.
Take them
that's
all.
Horrible that she's using her own child, though, as a weapon.
Well, I don't think she's using it as a weapon.
You pick
him
up by the heels and beat him with the head.
I think she used Barry
good weapons,
nothing, for nothing. A child.
Really?
I don't think she really needed
nothing. I've thrown out
married.
Three of them. I've got nothing.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you don't need to worry about that. I'm on birth control, and I don't want a baby because I like my body exactly how it is.
Wow.
And we do, too.
Good girl.
God,
she's
a good girl.
Chris, she's not really consistent with that.
Hey, I said.
I got her. I got her 3 cats. We're okay for a couple of months.
Pardon me. I said, if I do want to have kids, I want to have them later on in my 20s, so that I don't want to have them
later
when I'm 30.
On
later,
later
you're
20, when she's 25.
The older you have them, the harder it is to get your body back.
That's true.
And I said, if I do have his baby and my boobs start sagging down my ankles, you'll fix them with some good old-fashioned silicone.
How later on in your 20s?
Like 28, 29.
Oh, okay.
I'm 23. That's
23.
23 in 5 years.
And she's all real, too. God, what the fuck?
Well, they're not very big.
What,
so
what did you do? What did you do?
He was a Brady. Yeah,
what did you
do?
What happened to Bobby and his teeth and his hair? I mean, Bobby's just
brother.
A mess. What the fuck? You got abs?
There's nothing
you're
wrong
in
with
shape.
I remember when you were on what was the Surreal Life, and that that you're supposed to be the older guy and that young model, and then when you took your shirt off, it was the gayest moment on television. He went,
"What?
Hey, do you work out?" And you tried to blow him off. "Yeah, I work out a little bit." He's like, "You look like you work out a lot. I like to." He was so impressed at Chris's body.
It was, it's competition. It was competition.
Yeah. He thought he was going to be like an old dude, like a like
soft
Bobby looks.
Stuff,
yeah,
right.
With yellow teeth and no
Enough
tricep
with Bobby.
Muscles.
Yeah, what's
he
wrong
takes,
with Bobby? What is
I don't
Bobby?
Know,
what
with Bobby?
What are you, he's got good teeth. What are you talking about?
I'm kidding. It's relax.
Bobby, go brush your teeth.
I don't want it, Dad. I like chewing on candy bars and tobacco.
Love those. I love the little clips. Picture Peter walking through all happy.
Hey, Mom, look at this chick I'm dating.
But we've done that.
Yeah,
I know.
That didn't go over too big.
Well, that's because she wants to have sex with you, so she needs me out of the picture.
Oh. Jesus, really?
And what's
probably.
Wrong? What's wrong with that?
I don't know. She kept. There's nothing wrong with it, but to bluntly ask somebody
fantasy.
To.
What was the gayest moment on TV, though?
Well,
because you didn't finish the story.
That
what?
Was just. Well, he took his shirt off, and this other model, you know. He
Marcus,
was,
whatever.
Yeah, whatever his name was.
Shank my bird.
You know, he's shredded. He works out. You could tell he hits the gym a lot. And he was just looking at his body like, oh, my God, you'd work out too. Maybe we could hit. And he's trying to blow him. Everything he says, he's trying to blow him off. He's like, yeah, whatever, dude. Maybe we go to the gym tomorrow. We wake up at 5 in the morning so we can steam before the women wake up.
Me, you.
Marcus is definitely. Marcus,
we get the midget to rub us down.
I will totally stand up for him because Marcus is not gay. Marcus was actually very offended that I fell for Chris and not him.
Absolutely,
really?
Because he's perfect.
Marcus is
and
a
he's a regular guy.
He's
no,
actually,
he's not.
He's not.
No,
it's just,
he just doesn't
he
have
came
any,
across
he
as a bore
say
on that
anything
show.
Unless he has something to say.
He was so boring on that show.
Chris, can
he's
I?
Been, well, because we took the show from him because he wasn't, you know, doing cartwheels, smoking
right.
funny stuff, and getting naked in the jacuzzi, you
or
know.
Or peeing on the floor.
Or peeing on the floor.
Or picking up midgets by the head.
He speaks 6 different languages, and English is hard for him, and he gets a little, you know, scared if he's saying something right or not.
That version of The Surreal Life was the best one so far. I don't know how they're ever going to beat it.
The best thing ever. With that, when he was on that little wheelie thing they gave him,
oh,
the
awesome.
Lark. When he was on his lark.
Yeah.
And he
the
was
little
just
rascal on his
backing
little
up
rascal.
Into a, just keep backing up like a drunk driver.
We stole his key.
Really?
We stole his key. We put him in bed and stole his key.
He was totally asleep.
I love
that
when
entire time. Not with sleepwalking except on a scooter.
I love when he fell over. outside, and you kind of kept trying to hold him by his head to pick him back up.
Well, because tell them why he fell over.
No, I think that you're probably
going
to help me here, aren't you?
Uh-oh.
They didn't show this because he screwed someone at VH1 just so he can always look good in all the shows. But he picked up Vern and picked him up and spun him around and around and around and around until Vern got sick. Then he put Vern down. Then Vern was going like this.
Did you really do that?
Yeah, he felt obliged to have to take care of him because he's the one that screwed him up.
Son of a bitch. You came off like a superstar.
You don't spin midgets.
No.
over your head.
It was the funniest thing I ever saw, though, watching him spin him around.
But he came off like the caretaker, like nice guy.
I know, I was really
offended.
And you're
sitting there spinning the midget during commercials.
Yeah. So you ask me what I did? That's what I did.
Oh, God.
You know what he's saying? I'm all right. We couldn't figure it out.
Yeah. If you're all right,
like
you wouldn't
be
saying
it so much.
I'm all right. I'm all right.
Drunks like repeating themselves. We found that out with Steve-O.
Remember? Yeah. Ew, Steve-O?
Yeah.
He puts firecrackers in his butt.
Yeah, bottle rockets and
that
firecrackers.
That was so gross.
And didn't he put the little car up there?
No, that's the other dude.
He refused
the other dude
to do
from
it,
Jackass, right.
So yeah, anyway. That's reality television, my friends.
At its finest.
Yeah. I missed that.
And China was on the show, too, right, with you guys?
Oh, yeah.
She's a doll.
She was
sweet,
all over the place.
But she's crazy, and she was on
a lot she came
of
off really, like, out
but,
there.
But something happened.
Loosely tethered.
We used to have her on the show a lot, and she was relatively normal, and then, I don't know, after she left
she's
the wrestling world, she just...
Did you see the movie?
What movie?
No.
Oh,
the
porno?
Porno?
I saw clips and I showed him pictures.
Oh, you saw pictures?
Yeah, I saw
some. You know she has a small penis,
what'd you think about that?
She's got a small penis.
Oh, jeez. What'd you think about
that? That's from steroid use.
Can I ask you a question? What'd you think about that little mushroom cap?
Cheek.
Bob.
Wait, you have mushroom cap?
Think that perhaps steroids has its purpose.
Yeah.
There was something going on down there.
All swole.
Hey! Stop. She could kick your ass. I'd watch it.
Yeah, she'd make you blow her.
We're trying to get along with
an icon of a very
I love her. I think she's fantastic.
Can I be honest?
A very wholesome program that children watch. An icon.
I'm sorry, Chris.
No, it's all right.
Oh, yeah.
But China's
so innocent.
Do you watch
it? I just watched
really
him naked
friend
in a tub with her on TV. You don't think they're doing freaky stuff?
Do you watch the old Brady Bunch? Show?
No. I mean, I might have seen it when I was really young.
Phil Packer episode. Come on.
That's hilarious.
It's one of my favorites.
No,
puts
see,
the mustache on and goes out on a date.
My era was, you know, the only old show I watched was All in the Family. And the new shows I watched was like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air and Beavis and Butthead. So I didn't really watch the
You don't know what
Bunch
you're missing, though.
I'm missing the moral of the story, which I'm absolutely not interested in.
No, like little underlying things.
I think
pretty
he's
funny
happy.
She's got
attention
no Andy Griffith in her background.
Nothing?
She's got nothing. She doesn't... No Opie.
She's 20.
I think Christopher Knight's just happy that he can talk about something else besides the Brady Bunch finally, right?
I think he
really actually, I mean, it's, you know, I'll talk about whatever, but if people find the Brady Bunch still interesting...
But
I'll
mean,
hang. I'll hang. But
you got to be like Barry.
35 years later, I don't know what else I can say.
Barry was so sick of talking about the Brady Bunch. You finally got
another
hit show, so it's you know people are just focusing in on this more.
It's
they know
nice
where you came from.
It's
obviously,
nice to have something else to talk about.
Yeah, it must be.
I
like that people now know his name a little bit more because when we did the Story Life, we'd walk down the street and they'd be like, "Hey, it's the supermodel," which I'm not offended of, and. Oh, look, it's Peter Brady.
Peter Brady.
Like,
dude, every...
It's on your board that way.
Ah, it is.
On your calendar.
But you have a great
bastard
real name. It's like a porn star name.
Christopher Knight.
Tell him your real porn Knight star name. What is
Dickens
it?
Ledwell.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a good one.
Mine's Mink Mink Pandola.
Very good. When's the movie coming?
One Night in Curry? I don't know.
Yeah, that ain't going to come out.
That's like, dude, every day, though, right? Every day of your life for 35 years has been, hey, Peter Brady.
Hey, right. It's got him to score a lot.
Well, I don't doubt it.
Yeah,
but
it's just iconic.
But every
remember when Barry finally looked at us and said, my name's Barry? Cause we
yeah, could you stop?
Could you
hey,
stop?
Greg.
Like,
Brady
yo, Greg,
thing?
Greg,
we're
Greg.
Now hanging out a little bit. Could you call me by my real name?
Yeah.
Sorry, dude. So yeah. So is this relationship for real or is it for TV?
No, it's real.
We absolutely just fake everything.
Because I'll ask, though, because the whole Flavor Flav thing, they came in, it's like, this is so fake for TV, it was obvious.
She was
engaged. But look, we're attractive people. We're attracted to each other. And I don't know, that relationship was just really crazy.
She had a fiancé.
But they weren't living with each other. We've been living with each other since, like, January 2nd of this year.
I thought you were trying to kick her out.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't really successful.
He wanted his boyfriend to move in.
Let me ask you a question.
I'm realizing in this relationship, I am not going to get what it is I
Anything
want.
Anything you want.
Yeah. No,
you're
but not. That's pretty typical, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Please.
And that's why this relationship
you're getting
work.
What you want.
Listen to me. Yesterday was...
The world weeps for him. He sleeps with a 23-year-old girl that's into dominatrix.
Look,
thing.
And I've sort of engineered a life in where I lose
the
like
The sympathy
this.
In this room yeah, is overwhelming.
You really want your cake and eat it too, don't you, you ass?
He does.
Exactly.
He's well, basically
most
like...
Most of us are fucking fours, and you... we have sex with who we are. Okay, and you look at her. She's
That's
amazing.
A little too deep.
I would.
We have sex with who we
yeah.
are.
Oh, he's deep, all right.
I'm really deep. I fuck sinks. Okay, Chris.
And the H had sex with a sink.
Can we say the F word?
Yeah.
Satellite radio.
Oh fuck. Fabulous. Fucking fabulous.
Yes, it's satellite radio.
The age difference is what, 23?
5 years.
25
wow.
years.
God bless you, dude. Mm-hmm. God bless you. Seriously, man. God bless you.
It has no effect.
On what?
Only
the
for
age
him.
Difference.
Only for him. He's extremely anal retentive and very set in his ways.
You don't have to mind your manners here like you should have when you were Phil Packer in the restaurant kissing when your father had a big business client sitting in a booth getting repulsed by the kissing that was going on.
There was a little fondling. He was
there
repulsed
was some
by.
Fondling. It was awful, but, you know, you don't have to be like that here.
It was unvery un-Brady.
Nice.
Sorry.
Very nice.
I get that.
That was a
morning.
Sexy episode. That one.
The Phil Packer episode.
The most sex on that whole show.
This Halloween, you're going to go into the kitchen and change costumes and go back? Nothing? Nothing. Okay.
Oof.
Hey!
It was awful. Jesus Christ.
So your parents happy with the age difference and all that?
I
ask because I'm going through.
They love me.
I'm going through a similar. I'm going through a similar thing, and it took a long time.
My dad was not happy at first, but
yeah.
I convinced him to not kill him, and it didn't happen. My mom is not happy with him. He's a year older than my mother.
Your dad and mom grew up watching him on television.
Actually, my mom didn't watch very much TV. No,
wait,
they're very poor. So
wait, you're a year older than her mom?
Apparently.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh. I got a very
at
similar
same
thing.
Month
I,
of still, birth too.
I'm still working on the mom in my relation.
What's the delta?
Don't
between.
Tell her what he told my mom that you'll
Give
marry.
Me some advice.
He told my mom this. I'll marry your daughter when her her communication skills catch up with her sexual skills.
Oh no, your communication Jesus skills Christ. Catch up with your. Sexuality.
No, he said sexual.
I don't know what that really
so
do you, but I was drunk at the time. So.
Yeah, that's probably not a good thing to say to the
no.
parents.
I'm thinking it was.
And I get
true.
Along with my mother more than I do my father. So he impressed my dad, who we hardly talk, but it totally ruined
well,
stuff
now,
with my mommy.
Now I'm playing golf with my girlfriend's father. I'm in now.
Oh, really?
I still got to work on the mom a little bit, but. Oh, yeah.
How many years between you?
About 17.
Okay.
I thought
that's
17
hot.
Was a lot. You guys are 25.
How old is your girlfriend?
She's 22, 23.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, maybe we can have some coffee talk.
She's going to be 23 soon.
Go out and talk.
She's got to set up a little couple.
Is she hot?
Set up a club.
His girlfriend?
Ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
Okay,
but
how about me and her
but,
go out for lunch and you guys can go hang out
But I have
somewhere.
To say this every time, too. She's got an unbelievable personality and a sense of humor, too.
Is she bisexual?
Not all women.
Are you?
What?
You're going to, like,
She's
clam up now?
No, I'm just thinking about what I'm going to do to your girlfriend.
Wow.
Yeah.
She's on her way from Philly. She wanted to meet you guys, actually.
All hot
but
women.
She's a little late.
All hot women are gay.
No, I'm sorry, but
Wait,
unless
really?
You love a man, you're not going to really be attracted to him. Women are soft, supple, they smell good, and we know how to please each other better than a man does.
Yeah, but what about those cooties? That's,
yeah.
No, girls, cooties?
Mm-hmm. Women are good villagers. They like living in the village together.
I wish I could make
Is
a mattress
it?
Out of breath.
Yeah. They sleep together to, maintain
Wouldn't
village
a boob
order.
Right.
What are you, Buffalo Bill?
No, just have a realistic boob.
It takes a village.
For a mattress.
She roomy in the hips.
You got tape, working that outfit?
I had to.
All right.
Yeah. You'd be
because we're all hoping.
Out of that.
I wish
we're
you
all hoping.
Why did you have to ask that, Opie? You just ruined it for me.
Because you're thinking what
the
I'm thinking.
The whole show that it might slip out.
It
now I know it's not going to happen.
What's great about those type of... She's got one of those scoop... I don't... What is it called?
It's a sweeping,
very
neckline.
Very, very scoopy, like almost down to my belly button.
It's down our belly button.
Shirt.
It's very,
it's
light
Gucci.
Material. Very, very light. And it's barely... brushing against her breasts.
Do
the
like
whole
the
middle is, look at this. Wow. Yeah. That's amazing. Yeah.
And like I said, the world weeps for Chris for being able to tap it.
Yeah, tap it.
Too bad for you, dude.
Wow.
Yeah. I really feel bad for you.
I don't have
dude.
To do much in this relationship. Just sit back and just let her go.
Who knew you had game, bro? Come on.
You have to stay in shape, dude. You have to. You better not wind up like me.
I don't care if he gets fat as long as there's Viagra involved.
Oh, my God.
Are you really?
Viagra?
I think a guy, as long as his arms stay nice and fit, I like guts. I like guts.
There you go.
Yeah, you have nice arms.
Thanks, yeah, Robert, try a little harder. Robert's over there trying to flex just in case.
No, I just got to get... Hang on 1 second. I got to get my thing over here.
As long as you feel protected by your man, it's fine.
Why don't you show her your gut?
My gut?
Yeah, she doesn't mind if Chris gets fat.
Look at his underwear hanging out from...
What if Chris has to shimmy my elastic on my underwear up like a girdle? Hang on.
Yeah. Watch. If Chris had a gut like this, would you still be going out with him?
Chris, could you not look at me like that in disgust?
I'm sort of disgusted.
Could
yeah.
You not, hey,
but then
hey.
Again, I don't have to appreciate you. Adrian, what do you think?
Hang on 1 second.
Hold on. Chris, here comes the gut.
Hang
here comes the
second.
Gut.
Hang on 1 second.
All right.
He's getting prepared
he's
for that.
He's a drama queen.
So, you know, supposedly Chris got the washboard, right?
Hang on 1 second.
What if Chris
could you guys turn your heads in the back, please? Right. Stop giggling
really
and make... Like, this isn't enough.
What if he started looking like this? Go ahead, Bob.
I'm not even... oh, Jesus.
That's not bad. Actually, I would prefer Chris like that just because he only has, like, 3 hairs on his chest and, like,
hang on,
three
before
hairs
you, before
on
you say it's not bad, let me just turn sideways, okay? Here we go.
Can you make it roll?
Your torso like shouldn't that? Look...
No, but I can make it look like a little African starving baby. Look.
Dude, your torso, your torso should never look like a smiley face.
Jump up and down.
Dude, I tore my ACL.
Oh, yeah.
I broke my knee, dude. What do you want to do?
That was over a year ago.
Are you Starvin' Marvin from South Park?
Yeah.
The little Ethiopian boy?
So I got a little chunk. I'm sorry.
So what's up with the dominatrix thing?
Yeah,
on the show.
In control.
The poor guy's passed out after the thing. You guys.
How dare he? He's trying to make up for my Valentine's Day. Tells me to move out and then doesn't want to score with
me. He's so cold on the bed, and you're pulling his pants down. And
I didn't pull his pants down. I spanked the hell out of him. How dare he go to sleep? What's wrong with you?
Wake up, Peter.
He's going to kill you, man.
Of course he is.
Every no,
time
I was
you
really
play that, I see his eyes go, ugh.
I was really upset because on Valentine's Day, when I had planned a Valentine's Day for him and treated him like a king, I serviced him for like 2 hours.
Wow.
I love that word,
and
service.
I serviced
the
him
for
like 2 hours.
The hood's up, the oil's
and then,
changed.
You know, he
yeah, it makes it sound like it's one way.
Right.
Know? Yeah.
No, it was. I told you, lay down. I tied down your arms and stuff. That was one way. You couldn't move. But anyway, yeah, you remember that. Don't even lie. I blindfolded you too, and so I figured since we went out to eat, and he decided to totally shove his foot in his mouth and ruin the whole night for me, I should at least get laid. How
really?
Dare he go to sleep? Yeah, you know, I thought I was being pretty nice for giving him for telling me to get the hell out of his house on my Valentine's Day makeup dinner. Might as well get some cock.
Jesus! Oh. Wow. You could say fuck, but you can't say cock on
you
it.
You could say
no, I'm kidding.
It's going to say
because we really want to hear it from you. Let
all
us
right.
Say the cock.
Hey. Girthy penis. Is that better?
No, cock is better.
You know, some days, it was a mentally exhausting day.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah. And if you could just...
You just kept drinking champagne, stupid.
And if you could just... If you were into morning sex...
You're not into morning sex?
No, your breath smells so bad in the morning, and he's so gassy.
Oh,
I don't
want to
have sex. He'd be, like, pumping and going...
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, no.
We'd be halfway through. I have to poop now. You always have to poop right in the morning. I don't want to have sex with someone
hear
who's
this
full of poop.
About Peter Brady?
That is
Peter Brady's perfect.
That is just...
Peter Brady's a fictional 13-year-old character with an afro.
All right. But so
right here is the stud muffin.
He just had curly hair.
And he's got the bad breath in the morning.
You know what Notre family used to call
everyone
it?
Does.
Lion King.
They did not, and I'm tired of you saying that. They call my friend that. You say, well, I have a fucking baseball here.
Wait, what's that about?
What does that mean?
I had it. No, excuse me. Excuse me. I had it.
You're
a
storyteller?
I'm going to fuck you up.
Oh, big storyteller.
Oh, she's going to hit him.
No, seriously? My best friend was a fucking liar and always lied to my parents to have us go out and stuff, and she was an ex-girlfriend of mine, so we'd always lie about everything because we were little lesbians. And they called her Liza Minnelli, Lion King, and
that's funny.
True
Liza
Lies.
Minnelli.
And he sits there and he says the story's
where
about me because he's fucking old and he forgets
everybody
everything.
Everybody exaggerates everything.
I'd
there's
never,
there's
really?
A shred of truth, and everybody's exaggerating every story they tell.
I would
and they're just smack-talking everywhere.
I'd never treat you like this is all I'm saying. I don't think you lie. I don't think you lie, and I think you're an honest person, and you come from the heart.
I'm very honest. Everything comes out. I have no barriers.
That's what
your
I
boobs
think.
Aren't coming out, though, that's and that's what they want.
No, I don't want that. Chris, I don't want that.
Oh, what was that?
Oh. Pete, Chris, I got
some speak for yourself, Robert.
If
Pete?
There's one thing we've learned,
Bill
it's
Burr
honesty.
Would want to see the boobs.
As a matter of fact, you aren't able to go on a camping trip because you lied to your father. Actually, you came up, you told the truth at the end, but as I recall, Mr. Kramer still drove off without you.
This is really...
the most important thing was what? The truth.
I'm lost.
At the end of the episode, he looked and went, the truth.
Oh, you're talking about the Brady Bunch.
Of course I am.
I didn't know what you were
There's
talking about.
There's a lot of life lessons that you've missed.
Yes. See, and that's what I'm trying
Bunch.
To get to.
Right.
My sense of
my
truth
life lessons
was set early.
Is how
right.
Greg can fuck right. his mom and how you can tap Jan.
He never did
and
I never did.
Liar.
Yeah, what's up with
you
Ms.
at least did
No,
well.
Those, that's the truth.
What's up with Mrs. Brady? She's an actual therapist?
She's no, she's not. She's a hypnotherapist.
Said
are you
that
kidding
he
me?
Finger popped Jan. She just licked her fingers
that
and went,
so
you
so hot.
And
pre-braces or post-braces?
Well, you,
I think it was...
Was it by the craft services?
Now, I'm thinking it was an accident. He might have been in the carport when she was riding her bike without the glasses, and then she fell off the bike and fell right onto your fingers. Now, that... She's going to kill me.
They're having a little conference.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
What did I do?
No, nothing.
Are you going to lay into me now?
No, he basically just told me to stop pretending like he scored with somebody who's too hot for him.
Oh,
yeah, that's what I said.
Eve didn't want to do you. She wanted to do someone really hot.
Really?
Who? Yeah, he was a little kid. They were both little kids. Did you see him? He was scrawny until like age 23. He looked like he was 12.
He was the one, though, that came out of the whole thing in the best shape. Like, all of a sudden you were doing soap operas and guys, you'd tune in. Like, chicks were tuning in and going, wow. You know, Peter Brady, of course, but, you know, you kind of had something going after that. The other guys were
well,
all...
thanks.
Well, you did.
kind of, just a little bit.
Was that
you
a
came out of it.
It's very... to me, it looked like it was very difficult to kind of come out of that whole thing.
You came out of it like...
I didn't know you were running an independent Brady meter.
Yeah,
I am. I am the Brady expert.
He used to challenge Barry and would win all the time.
He knew
more about the Brady Bunch than Barry Williams.
Me and my sister would have a competition
when
the episode would start, who could tell what the plot line was just from a split second of
name that episode.
Was that good of a show?
Oh, it ruled. Yeah, it ruled.
It was the only show we watched.
I just thought it was for, like, just six-year-olds.
Yeah, it was. What can I tell you?
Is it kind of like Barney?
Is based around it. She goes, is it really that good of a show?
His whole life is based from running from it.
Can I ask you a question? What I look at you where you live now on the show that you're doing now, and what did you do before this show and before Surreal Life? What did you do for work? Did you act? Or?
Rob
Banks. He's a gigolo.
No. What were you?
I was in high tech. I was in the computer industry for 20 years.
And now you're retired.
Wow.
I decided to take some time away from the desk.
That's great.
Yeah, because it got a little claustrophobic.
And you
lived through the go-go 90s and then to the crushing, you know, later years of the high-tech industry where things imploded. Not that I was in anything internet, but nonetheless, it had an effect across the board.
Right.
Just about the time things
the fun
imploding.
Sort of drained out of it for me. I needed a recharge.
And you were married and all that?
Not all of it, but a good part of it.
Part
yeah.
of it.
You were married for a while there?
Yeah.
Did you get raked?
You got married twice?
Oh, no. Yeah.
No kids?
No, I actually didn't get buried.
Yeah.
He buried them.
Nice.
He buried himself in them. No, sorry.
Can't help yourself, can you?
No. Oof. I like that I can say whatever the fuck I want here. This is fabulous.
Adrian is the most sexual person.
No, wow. I'm not.
Yeah.
I just like to fuck.
See, she's lying again.
You guys want to have sex now? I will just sit around and watch. I mean,
no, when is your girlfriend getting here?
Yeah.
We have a wiffle ball bat.
When's your girlfriend getting here, man?
Let's see if I got a communique. No communique is coming in, so.
What do your friends think? You know, older guy that played Peter.
A lot of my friends at first were really disgusted with me.
Really?
Well, because I had sworn off
disgusted.
Men.
Disgusted? Why would...
I had sworn
jealous,
off men
right,
for... No,
oh,
I had,
right. They're
I'd
disgusted
sworn
that
men
you were
for,
the man.
Yeah, well, because I have a lot of feminist lesbian friends, and they're like, how dare you? And then they, you know, I kept telling them about him, and they saw him on TV, and they're like, wow, well, he's pretty charismatic and attractive. And I'm like, yeah, he's a really sweet guy. Mm-hmm. He's not just your typical, you know, joysy asshole.
They were
kidding,
mad. They were mad
kidding.
That they weren't going to get you anymore. That's why.
Probably.
Yeah. I'm going to do that whole little finger thing that you did before.
Oh,
she made the sound effect this time.
And you guys are still living together?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Second season coming or
what
no?
What are you giggling about?
Sister.
What are you giggling about?
She just cracks me up.
Why is that? Why?
She constantly cracks me up. Why? She's adorable. you got to admit it.
She might lie through her teeth, but she's adorable.
I am not
Don't call
lying.
Her a liar.
What is she lying
snaps.
About?
No, she turns not. Into Bobby when you...
I am not lying. No, I get so offended by it because you always tell me you're the most honest woman I've ever been with. I really like your honesty. And then whenever we're around people and I say something true, like you like to be spanked or have your nipples pinched, you're like, oh, she's a big liar.
You know,
true.
Chris, no, you're a shit talker.
Chris,
you got to let her be herself. Now, yeah. You knew when you tried to change your personality how poorly that went. You try to be like Humphrey Bogart, pork chops and applesauce. That personality didn't work. And finally, in the end, we realized just being yourself is really what was important.
And telling the truth.
And telling the
truth.
What
are you grabbing?
Got to do both.
Of course.
Oh. I was like, what are you grabbing down there?
She leaned over and kind of held. Yeah.
It looked like you were grabbing your penis.
I think the tape's starting to wear off.
Fans hyperventilating, trying to blow into the shirt to puff it up.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
No,
wow.
It's still working.
Damn it.
So how is this relationship going to end?
Who invented tape? Kill them.
It's double-sided tape. Kill the tape inventor.
Was that George Washington Carver?
Kill
somebody.
Mr. Scotch.
Mr. Scotch. That's what it is. It's double-sided scotch tape. Thank you, Scotch.
So where does the relationship go from here?
Ask him.
Does it have staying power?
Ah.
No, it's got staying power.
You going to be making out with any of her friends, Mr. Big Man?
Yeah, has she done that there for you?
No.
Oh, he did it to her.
What?
He made out with a friend, the lesbian go-go girl.
That was just...
You gave her tongue,
you
creep.
Let's not go there. She's still pissed off about that.
No, I'm not. I have absolutely no comment.
Who are we talking
subject.
About?
They were at a party, and the go-go, the girl from the
Jane,
go-go.
Jane Wheedley.
Jane.
Yeah, but she's... It was
a birthday party, and it was a joke.
Well, it is a woman who told me that she wanted you and got very mad and jealous even when she was married that I had you and she didn't.
Oh.
So it would be a joke if it was with someone who wasn't unbelievably attracted to you and wanted to ride your cock.
Right.
But it wasn't.
And yeah. And you closed your eyes when you gave her the tongue, too. So that's, you know, you did that shit. You closed your eyes.
So he wanted it, right?
Yeah, you seen passion in his eyelids when he closed it. And I remember that. And then you touched their side.
You're a very insightful man.
Yeah.
I did. I watched it.
And you're starting more problems.
I'm trying to break them up right
no.
now.
I know.
She said she likes fat guys. I'm all over it. All they have to do is have triceps. I can do dips every
fat.
Day.
And who knew you dated Cindy Margolis?
Now, the problem here is, though, you're wearing a Boston hat. She hates that.
Yeah.
What? You think I wouldn't trade in the Red Sox? I'd be a Yankee fan tomorrow if you tell me.
Good boy.
For you. Well, I'm not that
yet. What about
a
Cubs fan?
I'll be a Cubs fan. I'll watch women's lesbian softball, if that's what you're doing.
Well, you can watch me in the lingerie bowl. This
Super Bowl?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, where contractually they have to let their clothes fall away and
no.
do nothing about it.
Really?
No,
yeah.
Unless they pay me more money, I'm going in the fetal position.
Are we going to see him Playboy or anything? Well, I'm sure those offers are coming in.
There's been offers for a lot of things.
Yeah? Yeah.
Mostly gay porn. No.
You guys should make a video.
For you or Chris?
One Night in Curry.
One Night in Curry.
Nothing.
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 She wasn't listening, that's all. They weren't listening.
I know.
It's the audience you play
for. Yeah, I know. There's three or four different conversations going on
well,
at
you
all
know
times.
Well, you know who did do... a lot of young stars do gay porn.
They do.
The guy from the toy. The kid from the toy. He did porn.
Yeah.
The kid from Fright Night.
Yeah, he did some.
He actually became more famous in gay porn than he was in movies.
Congratulations
really?
To him.
No
wonderful.
Shit.
What a great gig.
I don't know how I know all this.
Yeah. Are you following gay porn? Is that how you know all this?
You have
this?
To keep up on the industry.
He knows everything about pornography.
He's following all the story.
Yeah, I'm a little freaky in case my chick wants to get down. I'll be there for her. I'll let her tie me up and I won't fart in the morning.
Oh, Lord. Talking about porn just reminded me. The other day we're watching this porno. We're about to get it on, you know, trying to get in the mood. I look up and my ex-roommate from when I lived in New York City is, like, sitting there just sticking it to this chick. And it was such a fucking...
Your ex-roommate was in the movie.
Yeah,
wow.
This guy, and he's an editor.
Fine, how do you do?
Yeah, he edits porn, but he lied to me. He said he was never in it. And then I'm, like, watching him, and he's this skinny, scrawny, ugly dude, and I'm just like, oh, and he had this, like, 12-inch penis. And
yeah.
It's just, remember that? I'm like, oh, my God, it's, what's his name?
She sounded very excited when she said 12-inch penis, by the way.
He wasn't in Rome, was he?
No, it was disgusting. HBO. It looked like it was a third leg because he's
you
so skinny.
You want to see my favorite porno?
Yeah.
Our favorite porno?
I personally like Sex and the Shitty.
This is our favorite.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
This is our favorite.
Century Sex.
Century Sex.
Did you really get to see this chick at Port?
Yeah. But she lied. She's only 87.
Wow. That's actually Ann B. Davis as the Century Sex woman. No?
Dude, she's a Christian lady.
I know. That she's very nice.
Cold.
I
saw. See, this chick isn't cold. So hideous, but this looks like this guy went into a nursing home and just...
Yeah. Started plowing.
Look at her boobs. They're like withered leaves falling off an autumn tree.
That's not going to happen.
I'm going to puke.
Yeah.
All right, we got some phone calls coming in. Let's say hi to Pat in Boston. Pat, what's up?
Hey, boys.
Hey.
Two-part question. I wanted to know who does the laundry, because if I remember, a young Christopher has trouble with the laundry. And I want to know if any robes got ruined back in the day when Chris overloaded the laundry with detergent.
Unfortunately, that wasn't Peter. That was Bobby that had problems
with
the laundry.
You got to keep it straight, my friend.
I blow it. Punch.
He was trying.
Yeah.
Rob in Miami. Rob?
Hey, how you doing, guys?
All right, Rob.
Hey, Chris, you know, I saw the show the other day, and I see why you're dating this chick. But the other 23 hours a day when you're not banging her, how have you not gouged your eyes out with a spoon?
The same reason I haven't gouged your eyes out.
She is ignorant. Good God.
Gee, that's cold.
Defend me. I'm your woman. Defend me, you fucking prick.
That's all he said was, that's cold, dude.
Defend me, you fucking prick.
Jesus Christ.
Well, what fucking kind of man is that?
I'll defend you, you motherfucker. You don't talk to her like that, you redneck son of a bitch. I'll kill you.
I'll kill your fucking family. I'll stab you in the throat, you cocksucker.
Hey, what supermodel are you fucking, darling?
Hey, there you go.
There you go.
She's getting all upset. Let me calm
you
down.
I'm not getting upset.
Let me calm you down a little bit.
Just tell the guy to fuck off. That's all.
Birds
hey, some things
never
aren't worth responding
sang
to.
Before. Flowers never grew.
I have no idea.
Ponies never ran before.
Oh, my God.
Till I met you.
Him.
Yeah,
he just threw a baseball at my head. He's had it.
That could have fucking hurt him.
I could have had it.
Thrown
oh,
higher.
Is that classic?
Oh, Christopher.
Christopher just threw a baseball at my head.
He's had it,
man. That is yeah. He hit him in the neck.
Thank you. He's had it, man. He couldn't take it anymore.
That is not nice.
He was trying
was
to... I didn't want to break the window.
Perfectly acceptable.
So I didn't throw it hard.
For singing that lousy song.
He was trying to calm you down, though.
Mm-hmm. I was already calmed down. All he has to do is tell the guy, fuck off.
Don't make me break into makeshift model TA.
You have to throw a baseball at Anthony's trachea. Jesus.
I'm dying. I'm sorry,
she's
but
lost all,
that was some funny shit.
It's lost on her, but I hear you.
Chris, what do you have to say about that guy that was on the phone?
Oh, he's just some rat.
You know, how do you respond to that? I mean, some things aren't worth responding to. The fact is that our relationship is multi-layered, and there's, you know, a lot of it edited out for the show. To think that everything is to, you know, be mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
And Adrian is a little over the top at times, but she's also the sweetest, you know, kindest, aww, and the most loyal person I've ever met.
And seen.
Ugh! Sorry. Oh. I hate him.
Oh, George Bush.
Die.
On TV.
Die, Jesus.
I don't like it. He will. Someone's going to assassinate him.
Oh, boy.
Here we go. Oh, boy.
Don't say that.
We're going to get a visit.
It's going to be Greg Brady. No, I'm kidding.
We're going to get a visit.
We're going to get a
visit.
She's
got really bad karma.
I don't like any politician. I'm sorry. So sue me. They're all liars.
They will.
She loves heaping bad crap coming to herself.
Hey, yeah. Let's quickly change the subject. Let's say hi to Mike in Jersey. Mike?
Hello, Mike in Jersey.
Hey.
Morning, boys.
Hey.
I just want to know if this chick's in the ass sex.
Oh, Jesus.
What's that?
Ass sex.
Anal.
Oh, that.
Anal.
I just bought a book called The Beginner's Guide to Anal Sex, and I bought a little, it's called Little Red, a little
Can you believe this book, and it's got like 90 pages in it. I mean, what could you be talking about for 90 pages?
I'm trying to learn a lot of women. I haven't done, you know, done it yet and
it's her way
been
of stalling. She just wants to read about it.
No, it's just all my friends told me. Well, it took about a good 13 times before I enjoyed it.
13.
I'm like,
13 is the lucky number on that one.
This guy is girthy. He doesn't have some small little prick that I'd be comfortable with, okay? I'm a little scared.
Yeah, that's, yeah. So I have to read the book.
What you're going to do is get your knees and put it right into your stomach.
Oh, that's
is that,
so
that helps
wrong.
For you, Bob?
Wait a minute. What am I talking about? I don't know. I mean, that's what I've heard through the internet forum.
Well, I can do that through my mouth, you know.
Jesus Christ, I'm in love with her.
Wow. Sandy Kane's here.
No.
Just showing that God has a sense of humor, man. look at the fucking... If you don't think God has a sense of humor, man, you mix the DNA one way and you get this lovely creature that's in the studio, and then you mix it another way and look at the horror show outside the studio right now.
Yeah, they are 99.9% the same.
The same.
All right, a few phone calls coming in. Let's say hi to Carl. What's up, Carl?
Hey, how you doing? I just wanted to know if Chris Knight, did he come up with that Valentine's Day episode for the show, or is that scripted?
No, most of the stuff is not.
It was suggested to him because he's not that romantic.
Well, I mean, the fact is that I needed to do something to make up for the kiss.
Man, I was crying, bro. It was great.
Oh, good. Good. Yeah, I kind of screwed it up for late in the night. So.
Are you going to shoot steroids in a future episode like good old Danny?
No, we leave that to Danny. Bonaducci? We leave that to Danny.
Holy crap.
Yeah, let him slit his wrist, shoot the roids.
Hey,
yeah.
Danny's a nice guy even though he's a little crazy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he's out of his mind.
You going to throw a baseball at him, too?
We got a guy.
Yeah, a little anger management.
I'm so sorry he did That's that okay. to you. That's so sad.
I deserved it.
I've never seen him do anything like that.
You see the way he just looked at me? He looked at me for a second. He was going to throw something in my face.
I don't have a ball left.
We got a guy named Buddy Hinton on the line.
Buddy Hinton.
Oh, no. Buddy, what's up?
The only violence in the Brady Bunch, right?
Right, true, yeah.
Hey, do you remember me? Baby talk. It's no wonder you can walk. That girl sitting next to you there, I'm going to bang her someday while listening to Time to Change.
You shut up, Buddy Hinton.
You got something in your hand right now? What are you doing? Okay, good.
He's got nothing.
Hey, man.
Got nothing.
Considering Chris is the first guy I've banged in 3 years, I highly doubt that. I'll be a lesbian after you. They're much better.
Wow. Are you going to go back to girls eventually?
If he screws this up, probably.
See, it's all in my hands.
All in your hands.
Why is it all his fault?
No, it's not. I don't think that's what is that, a fate worse than death to sleep with women?
No. Why is, you said if he doesn't screw the relationship up.
Because I was never really into men before.
No, never.
I have a feeling you're going to screw up this relationship.
I think you're going to fuck.
Call me crazy, but I have a feeling that it's not going to be good old Christopher Knight that messes this one up.
I treat my baby like a king, don't I?
Yes, you do.
Just check. Do me a favor. Check under the pillow for an ice pick.
Oh.
Believe me. Like last night, she starts pummeling me. I feel like I'm like in a,
I've
I'm
never
in the corner
done that.
With Oscar De La Hoya. And all of a sudden, she's just beating on my chest.
I had a dream Patrick Swayze was trying to steal my food. I'm not kidding.
And, of course, when I heard that, then I understood. It made all the sense in the world.
I don't like that.
Because you don't want Patrick Swayze stealing
your
food.
I've had that same dream.
Stealing your food?
Well, I had lasagna, and he was all like, it was the end of the world,
bastard.
And I had the only food.
End of the world, okay, sure.
And Val Kilmer was there, and I had to feed him enough. And then here comes Patrick Swayze trying to steal my food.
Nobody puts Brady in a corner. No?
I didn't mean to. I woke up and
felt
line, so
you know,
bad.
That stupid movie.
Because normally he's the one that kicks like me around. I'm sorry, baby.
All right. That's all right. They're making up now, so it's all good,
thank
right?
goodness.
All
right, you didn't hurt me.
Ben, were you all right on time? You guys having fun?
Yeah.
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 Yeah, sure.
I want McDonald's.
As long as I keep my mouth shut.
I'm so sorry you threw a baseball at
you. It's okay.
I was shocked. I've never seen any sort of like...
It hit my arm.
It was high and tight.
It hit you right here, dude.
It kind of rolled up.
It hit you in the jugular.
That's all right. It kind of rolled up my arm.
You got Sunshine Day there?
It's Sunshine Day. Everybody's smiling. Sunshine Day. Everybody's laughing. Sunshine Day. Everybody needs. Everybody.
Someone's laughing at you.
Seems so happy today.
I can't remember.
I don't either.
You think I know?
You're the only one that couldn't sing, right?
Yeah.
And I still can't.
No, he can too. He's a great baritone.
It was time to change.
Yeah, it was time to change.
Had to change the whole song for him.
They had to.
Oh no.
Yeah. It's time to change.
Have you heard this one yet? No?
That's Barry.
Is that Greg?
Yeah.
It's not just season, but you know it goes for everything. Oh, you guys sing some gay music.
Hold on, this part's coming up,
Maureen. Yeah.
Do you smoke bongs to this kind of music?
Not yet. Yeah. Oh.
Oh, it's kind of cute.
Isn't it? You gotta wait for, you know, the Peter part, though.
I don't think you're gonna hear it, because this is from the CD, right?
Studio version.
Studio version doesn't have it.
Only episode version? Damn it.
Did you guys actually sell albums?
Barry really tried.
Yeah.
Barry really was selling
it. Sold a few.
Barry was selling it.
Yeah.
It's kind of cute. It's like something I think I'd watch like when I was in my Barney, or listen to while I was in my Barney days. It's cute. It's like it's
cute.
She
watched Barney. She had Barney days.
She went from Barney right to Beavis and
Butthead. Well, I'm into like Nine Inch Nails and Tool, so I don't think
I love
that.
Tool.
Oh, Tool fucking rules.
Just
the other day, I put it on. He's like, "What's this fucking noise?" I said, "How dare you get out of my
car?" You don't like the Tool?
Nah.
Tool's sorry.
What a freak.
What kind of music do you like there?
He doesn't like any. Like, I'm sitting there jamming to Pink Floyd, and he tells me to turn it down. Led Zeppelin, turn it down. The Doors, turn it down. Get out of my car.
What do you listen to? Like, Tony
Myself
Robbins?
Think.
Myself
Think. Oh, you don't like music?
I know. He likes to throw on a Silver Platters disc every so often. The Silver
Platters.
I love
too
listening
loud
to Johnny Bravo.
Johnny Bravo. Sure.
All right, let's say hi to Dan in Connecticut. Dan, what's up?
So sorry, Chris.
Dan. Hey, what's up, Dan?
Oh, yeah, I thought maybe Anthony could play the Marsha Brady song for Peter. Let him know how much he really loved the show.
The Marsha Brady song?
Yeah, that was the Marsha Brady song.
What's the Marsha Brady song?
It's just a song I
about
penned with my old band from
years
ago.
I've got to hear it.
It was about Marsha.
Yeah.
All right, we can play a little of this.
Back? All right. But the heat she created for you?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Well, all I hear all day long in school is how great Marsha is at this, or how wonderful Marsha did that. Marsha.
Anthony on lead vocals.
Oh, thank you. Okay. Looking at the screen, what does this feeling mean? I got this shiver way down deep in my loins. The blonde head beauty, and who ain't she a cutie? The best in every club that she joins. She was the best, always. She teases all the fellas, her little sister's jealous. Goddess from her head to her toes. Well, she wears a groovy skirt with a flowered print shirt. She's turning heads wherever she goes. Yeah. Black and White Zenith TV. First
she
boner.
She was hot, man.
Yeah. One of the proudest moments of my life. Billboard Junior High, her sparkling blue eyes. The smile anyone would die for. Well, I almost shot my load at the Hawaiian episode. The mommy started knocking on my door. She's sweeter than a peach in her bikini on the beach. The other girls couldn't compare. Yeah, and what a piece of ass when she took that hula class. Her skirt so short I think I saw her hair. I did.
I got to get a copy of that.
You need a copy of that one?
I need a copy of that.
Because he agreed. He got his very first
brilliant.
Phone. And
thank you, Chris.
Yeah, she really was. She's got
hot.
So much power because she was everyone's first crush.
She was hot.
These are people running all the largest companies in America today.
Right.
Right.
Back then, man, you watched
she was
that show.
First.
The blonde hair, the wholesome, the whole thing. Oh, it was perfect.
She got it. Beautiful.
You know, she's still hot now. She looks exactly like she used to.
Slow down.
Let's say hi.
She almost does. She hasn't aged at all.
Easy.
Yeah.
Let's say hi to Prozac.
Great interview, Boris. Great interview. I had a question for Christopher there. Let me get this straight. You're having sex and you got to take a morning shit with this hot chick?
No, that was all shit talking.
No, you take a morning shit every morning, like three times in the morning.
Wow.
So what's that got to do with anything?
It's gross knowing you're doing something that's going to have to take a poo right when you're done.
It's not like I'm going to take a shit on her.
One more question.
She goes to the bathroom, yeah.
What's in her pants? That's what I want to know.
What's in my pants?
What's in her pants?
What do you think there's
what
a
kind of hairstyle?
Penis?
I guess as far as a hairstyle, yeah.
It changes. It changes. Mostly nothing.
That's nice. The wood floor, we
call
it.
Right now, I have a very, very thin lining strip.
Hitler mustache. No, the Hitler mustache is when you shave it way down. You have the line, but then you shave it down to that dot.
No,
that doesn't make sense unless they're standing up with their legs together.
I do
sort
not
of like
have
an exclamation point without the dot.
Right.
Yeah,
exactly.
It just hangs high.
It's about this long and about as thin as my pinky.
That's the mohawk, the landing strip.
Yeah.
The mohawk landing strip.
Yeah,
it's when you're drunk. Put your
could
cock
be a mohawk
there.
Oh, wow. So exactly where to what?
Adrian is the most beautiful woman everywhere.
Yeah. Oh,
that's my favorite. That's his favorite part of my body.
Wow. Well, of course.
He praises it all the time. No, he won't sit there and look at it.
No,
it makes me uncomfortable.
She's a flawless, like a museum.
Absolutely.
Yeah, he just
real.
Wants to like look
flawless
at it like
specimen.
It's a Picasso.
He wants
like,
to stare at your vagina like the pyramids.
Yeah.
Well, some girls
hopefully
tend
not like
to be
a
little messy.
I feel like
it would
there.
Be up on your cheek or something.
You know what? I agree.
You don't
want to
mess
some,
down
there's
there.
There's some hacked meat. Some
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. It looks like an explosion at the Steakums factory.
It looks
sometimes.
Like, ever see like a manta ray just flowing through the sea?
Yeah,
some of them look
yeah.
like a manta ray. Just
you don't want that. You want it to look like a nice clamshell.
Yeah.
All everything like self-contained.
Yeah. I feel like Carl Sagan.
Like
I appreciate her inner space like he did outer space.
There you go.
You unzip her pants. It's like bat wings. It flies across the room.
No, you don't need that.
That's nasty.
No, mm-hmm. I appreciate you liking my body. It's just, I don't know, sometimes I get embarrassed. You stare at it
do
a
you
lot.
Just stare at her ass?
He stares.
You gotta lay. You gotta lay down on the bed on her belly and what, do you just rub her ass?
She's an athlete. She's got muscle tone. She's just
like
she's well put together.
No, she's 22.
Wow. Yeah, but you know something? No,
I'm in the gym
22.
6 days a week because there's a lot of fat 22-year-olds out there.
Yeah.
I mean, you're
right about that.
I'm not soft and skinny. I am ripped everywhere. I'm very proud of it, and it takes a lot of hard work.
Well, you should be.
Well, we got to take leaks and dumps and stuff. So.
Ah, goddamn.
Yeah,
it's right.
Morning for crying out loud.
Yeah, it is.
Like, I'm unusual.
You guys probably sleep till noon, right?
You all want to take dumps together?
Yeah, let's take dumps.
Let's,
I got to dump.
Let's all just line up
he
in the
poops.
Stalls.
He poops in front of me, but I haven't been able to poop in front of him.
Hold on, we talked about
him.
That. I don't think that's
let
good,
me ask you a question,
good
Chris.
As far as the relationship goes.
My girl... I have to, the beginning of the
you
taking,
have a girl.
Dropping a deuce.
Surprised that you have a girl. You have a girl.
He's such an asshole.
You know what?
You
know what? You learn nothing from the Brady Bunch.
Nothing.
You're a mean person. I'm going to tell Florence. I don't think Florence would appreciate your vile sense of humor.
Go
now
ahead.
You're just
go
making
ahead.
Sure he
go
will
ahead.
Steal
what
me.
What is
man.
The problem in the morning?
Listen to me. Hang on while I flex my muscles. She can't be there at the beginning when I push it out, and at the end when I wipe it out.
But
in the middle,
she can walk in and grab a little lipstick, grab a little Q-tip, and
like
come in
and
out.
Like she wants to be there, then that's when it smells the worst.
Not that she hangs in there, but she'll come in and out. But at the beginning, if she's got to go, she can't watch me. Get there, push it
she
out.
She just want to hear the noises. But
is it her
smell?
Problem or your problem? What happens if she walks in at the beginning? Does it go back?
I tell her to beat it.
Does it go
I tell
back?
Her to beat it.
What happens if
beat
she did?
I tell her to beat it.
What
I
happens
get,
if
I
she
get,
did?
Get the fuck out or I give you a fresh one, whore. That's what I say. You learn how to talk to your woman,
would
Chris.
You just, would you just hang there indefinitely
wants,
if she just stayed there?
Yeah.
I swear he wants me to see
back
him poop.
Up.
I mean, I told him, I'm like, sometimes it's kind of unattractive to hear the kerplunk, kerplunk, kerplunk.
I don't know. I don't
it's
like when you hear the sausage
stuff.
Being
I mean,
pushed into the shell.
I don't get what the
that
big
sounds.
Deal is.
And 3 a.m, that's very healthy.
I'm used to it now.
I don't get what the big deal is.
But he started, like, after a week of dating, this man started pooping with the door open. I was like, whoa, man, are we already there?
I poop with the door open.
Because
you never
right.
know when you need something.
That's the definition of anal retentiveness.
You know, so what are we going to see on future episodes? We should give the big plug here. My Fair Brady.
You're going to see...
VH1, Sunday nights at 9:30.
You're going to see him meet my 6'7" redneck father from Little Rock, Arkansas?
Holy wow, boy. Shit. Are you kidding me?
No.
Did you get drunk beforehand? hopefully.
Nobody got drunk with him.
Oh, that's good.
We went fishing.
It's a good bonding thing.
Went fishing. And then, fishing.
And then my dad told you he'd kill you.
Yeah, and then I
got that speech, too. Yeah.
Then I got drunk and frustrated with her mother and made her cry.
Oh,
you
God.
Made her mother cry?
Oh, I'm proud about that. I still got a lot of work to do to make up for that.
Why'd you make her cry? Well, we got to wait to see,
you think I went in trying to make her cry?
And we go to Puerto Rico where he tells me I have cellulite.
Right.
Oh, no.
Where?
Where's the cellulite?
I would be more than happy to drop my pants and ask you if you think you see cellulite. But I have to respect him. Can I drop my pants?
Are you insane?
No! You know what they call you in the business? They call you a party pooper.
It's my party.
Yeah, there you go. It's his party, and you are so not invited.
But you're supposed to invite friends to your party.
Yeah. No.
It's a party in my pants, and I guess Christopher Knight is the only one that
we were this close
VIP
to seeing if she had cellulite.
Why'd you have to ask?
I don't have any.
You don't have...
I hardly even have skin on my
bones.
She set
me up. She says, Chris, is this cellulite?
And it wasn't.
Yeah.
And then you said everybody. You told me I had cellulite. I go on.
Watch episodes of My Fair Brady, like the one that aired last night, of me scrubbing my car, and it's a full butt shot, and there is not one dent there. Not one. It's just he got mad.
Is it like you sat on a pebble, or is it like...
No, I started gaining a little weight, but it looked fabulous. I got these big old boobs. I finally had an ass, and he likes Ethiopian women. He doesn't like real women.
It didn't look like cottage cheese.
No.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'11".
Wow. And how much you weigh?
How much do I weigh now?
Well, we could ask.
132.
Yeah, that means she's perfect.
You're going to go to your chart, Opie?
You don't have
or
to go
just
to
figure just out that Jesus. Works.
We have a chart then.
How much did you weigh during the cellulite moment?
During the cellulite moment. Afterwards, I'll tell you, after that moment, later on, like a month later, I gained weight. But you know why? I started that birth control that does that. And that's hormones. You can't help it. But I snapped back to it, and I started working out. At the time, I weighed 140. Ooh. So I had bigger boobs. I had, like, C-cups. They're fabulous.
Awesome.
This guy wanted Bs.
You're really a fucking picky guy.
Jesus,
you really don't settle for anything less.
Yeah, but do you know what
kind of self-help books have you been reading for the last 20 years?
Do you know what makes me happy? He's lost a lot of muscle, and he has cute little love handles now, and it just really makes me happy, because I'm in the best shape.
He does.
I noticed it on the show. You weren't as hot as you were on Surreal Life.
He's still fucking hot. He's still fucking hot.
He's got to remember to eat at this point. I mean,
all he's got to do is look better than Mike.
Yeah.
All he's got to do is look good, period.
That's all he's got to do as a Brady is look better than Mike. And you're fine.
He's the best looking one, if you ask me. He's
if
aged
you ask
the best.
Me
out
too.
Of all of them.
Who's the worst one?
Who's the worst one?
Who aged the worst?
Don't get into it.
Yeah, don't get dragged into
I don't
this.
Think. I don't think
they're
anyone's.
All friends.
I don't think anyone's.
Oh, they're not like
ugly.
The fucking Partridge Family.
I don't think anyone's ugly,
each other
but
anymore.
I'll tell you what. It's not that she aged the worst. I think she aged the coolest. I like Susan. She was such a cute little girl, and she turned out to be such a defiant badass, and I actually like that.
Yeah.
I'm sure we get
why.
Along.
Look at her. She,
defiant
everything she
badass.
Says is sexy. I'm sure we get
the
along.
The youngest one's defiant badass. It wouldn't have fit.
I like Susan.
I do. I like Susan. I bet Susan would smoke a bomb
you
with me.
You got to change the tune.
Yeah. All right, we should let these lovebirds go.
Hey, man, thanks for coming in. What a pisser.
He threw a baseball at you.
You know something? I've had Rutger Hauer throw pencils at me. And I've had Christopher Knight throw
a baseball
at me, and I enjoy the baseball more than the Rutger Hauer pencils.
Don't play
ball.
Thank
you.
As a matter of fact, if you
could
sign that baseball for me, I will treasure it. I will treasure that.
Draw a picture of my vagina. No.
Yeah, but do it like
that's
in school.
He just drew it.
No, he didn't.
Oh, wow. Yeah, he did.
My favorite.
Nice.
That's all you get. Wow. Jesus.
A little sketch.
It's a coin slot.
Oh.
That is not my vagina. That doesn't look anything like...
It's like a parking meter.
It looks like a pair of legs with like a leaf
I
on
think
top.
It's a pretty good anatomical diagram.
No.
Anatomically correct?
I mean, you can't draw my vagina. My vagina's too good. How much hair are you putting on there? Oh, okay.
At least he draws better than he fixes bicycles, because, as I recall, he wasn't able to hold down that job fixing the bike. He had the heart and everything, but he just wasn't what they call mechanically inclined.
Chris, I'm so glad you started dating me. He would have never done anything like this prior.
Old bastard firing you. You're just a kid, for God's sake.
You brought the wild side out of
him. Show him how to do the work. It's a bicycle, not a car.
She's actually sent by the devil. The Brady Bunch is all we had left as a culture to hold on to goodness. And
yeah.
She's going to make him a bad
and
little
now she's
deviant.
Spanking
who
like
says
Peter
I'm
Brady
not an
on
angel?
TV
you know, look at the description
wow.
of hell. Hell is
there's
sin,
great,
sex, bisexuality, drugs, rock and roll.
Right.
Don't that's you think that's really heaven?
Breath. She's the devil.
Wow, that was very deep.
She really
well, I like that.
Oh, shit.
Chris!
On top of my finger. I had a glove at what
that
I caught that.
That is fucking funny, man.
Anthony, stick up
you.
For yourself.
Watch out.
Yeah, really. Throw it back
at
him.
Something.
That's
who carries Rick? Throw it back at him.
That was good times. if he was to cast some good times, you'd be hitting him with a club right now.
Right.
Stick up for yourself.
All right, we got to say goodbye to these guys. It's My Fair Brady. It's on VH1, of course, Sunday nights at 9:30. This was great, guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks,
thank
man.
Thank you.
We had a blast.
For featuring my vagina on your show.
And with that, we're all going to go take dumps, so we'll be back.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, we're back with the Opie and Anthony program on XM Satellite Radio. Robert Kelly sitting in for Bill Burr, who usually sits in for Jimmy Norton.
What a clusterfuck
Jesus
we got
Christ.
Here, huh? We're on the third string.
We certainly are on the third string. My God.
Like the Jets over here.
We started with David Lee Roth. We got the Sammy Hagar. Now we're down to Gary Cherone.
Oh, man. You call me Gary Cherone, fucking Hardy Boy asshole.
Bobby's starting to look like a Chinese movie bodyguard. He really is looking like Toru Tanaka right now.
I'm going to take my hat off and throw it at your neck.
The toughest, the invincible Chinese bodyguard. Go through Hazuki. You need a top hat.
Oh, holy
Patrice O'Neill in studio. What do you think of Peter Brady?
Oh, he's holy finished. Jesus. God bless him. He's going to shoot himself at some point. He's going to get in the middle like that tic-tac-toe box and just boom. After that junkie gets finished with him.
Oh. That's the music that he blows.
He has absolutely no control in that relationship. No control.
You can see the
he's just waiting for her
face.
To shut down the pussy.
I hope he's had enough like of that 60s booty. When did that show come out? 70s?
Mm-mm.
Well, I think he had enough booty that you don't think he's going to be that spellbound over her.
No? Oh, he probably got a lot in his day.
Yeah,
I'm
so
sure.
It's just bringing back. It's like it brings back his old, you know, when it's time to change.
She's like 5'11". She was wearing heels, so she was like 6'1", 6'2". He's maybe 5'4".
Yeah.
Chris, I'd like to talk to you about something. It's the end. It's over, Chris. I'll let you glance up at me and your family for a while. I'll stay in this square. You can just be over there looking over at me for the last time before I tip my hat and get the fuck out of your life.
That is the best organ ever.
Just over.
I just wish I didn't see her face. If I just saw a body, I'd be like, wow, you know. But I saw a face.
You
and
saw
that
the
just,
yeah,
that
right?
Just is just evil.
He's pure. He's praying that VH1 picks up a second season so he can continue the relationship.
Oh, she's built like a heroin needle. She just long needle neck.
That is just some high maintenance. That is some high maintenance on that one.
Thank you for not having me in here so I could piss off the Hollywood manager that was out there.
Oh, is that what you were doing?
Schmecky McGillicuddy.
And then Anthony got a baseball thrown at his head.
Yeah, I started singing.
I saw you when you were doing
it. I started singing one of the old songs.
And he finally had it.
I think too many Brady references in his life where he just doesn't want to hear them anymore. It's very, you know something, there are barely any Peter-oriented episodes. So I really had to dig deep, goddammit.
He
should have appreciated that.
The one with his bad voice was like,
that was one of the big ones. Yeah.
The other one,
Marcia, Oh My Nose,
and
huge
the pork
one.
Chops and apples.
Pork chops and applesauce is a big catchphrase. Yeah, and Phil Packer, when he dressed like Phil Packer with the mustache and went out with his brother as the older date.
What about the one where he changed into the vampire back into the other costume? That was a big one.
No, that's not good. Where he's running back and forth.
The tiki.
The tiki's a big one. Oh, shit, I forgot to play that while he's here. Damn it.
That's what a pussy sounds like when you go down there.
I would have gotten the ball thrown at me again. Remember he's on Surreal Life? Yeah. I saw it. The dude is built like a...
Not anymore, though.
He's getting a little doughy. No.
He's
she
losing
even
it.
Little doughy.
She said he's getting a little doughy.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, now he's got that, so he doesn't have to work for it.
Yeah.
But well, no, it's not even about that. He's like, he doesn't trust her to leave her alone for a second so he could go to the gym
for a little bit.
Punches.
Yeah, he's
you think he's just eyeballing her every second of the day?
He should learn how to shut himself down on that one there, man. He should just, he should seriously try to learn. That's what I do with my girl. My girl is completely out of my league. I treat her like shit.
What, do you wean yourself off of her? So in case she ditches you, you're fine?
Mentally abuse them enough where they start to believe you're sexy. And they start to believe that you'll get somebody just like them.
Yeah? Is that how it works?
You have to, man.
By the way...
I'm a mess.
By the way, Patrice...
But she thinks you're the shit.
She loves me, man, because, you know, she loves me.
Good. Let's say hi to Prozac. Prozac, what you got?
I learned Peter Brady's chick is built like a heroin needle with a coin slot pussy.
Yes.
And that Bob Kelly's a fat chink who's also a nigger cook.
Jeez. Please. Jesus.
Thanks, everybody.